So consider the following complicated cases. Our sensors are not as accurate. They're not perfect. So in some case, this discontinuity of the left sensor going from 0.5 meter to 2.5 meter might be a faulty error. Maybe there's a mirror there. Maybe there's a keyhole. I went through that laser, went that little keyhole, and it's not really an unexplored room. But the we want to think in a way that in high probability, if there is an intersection, our notion of detecting a discontinuity as in a potential branch or a potential room that need to be explored is a good notion. Moreover, not every intersection would actually lead to unexplored area, because it just might be a dead end or a very narrow corridor that I not need to go all the way in. I might be just performing a slight yaw in order to map the entire little corridor that I haven't seen before that. So assuming I'm a robot of a diameter of 0.5 meter, then jumps or discontinuity smaller than 0.5 meter in a way encapsulate maybe path that I cannot go through, because each of the laser sensor points are kind of a barrier, are kind of a reflection from a wall. So if I have one point here, another point there, and my vacuum cleaner, my robot is larger than that, it's that big, then there's no point to think of it as an unexplored region, but because I cannot go through it. So I also have a kind of a self measurement of what is an interesting corridor to go through. Luckily, our width as humans are more or less as the vacuum cleaner, so we have more or less our building in our corridors, rooms, doors, and so on and so forth, are in a way in the same proportion as a vacuum cleaner.